Guess who got brands talking? Brandlive.co.za.
Let's get your creativity flowing. This show has got all the juice on all your art news. None of that riff-raff, just real authentic art from the coolest young creatives. You are now tuned into Carve Radio. Carve Radio with Lep and my Fadi.
Are we in?
Hello, 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 and welcome to it. Yes, once again, we are back on in 27 Boxes right here in the Brand Live Studios with myself and Leseho, of course. Hey, Leseho, how you doing?
Hello, beautiful.
You know, I'm really blushing on a Monday. He's such a flirty guy, you know. Flirting is meant to be for the weekend, you know. Now it's Monday. We should be serious at this point. No. How was it? How was your weekend? What did you get up to?
No, my weekend was good, man. My sister's in town, so it was a lot of family things. You know, I'm happy. I missed her.
Nice.
And yeah, man, just lazing around with my sis. I haven't seen her in like 2 months, I think.
So this Monday has nothing to do with a hangover and like last week.
Nah,
can
I get again? No, because I'm not bad.
Can we clap for him, everybody? You know, can we be happy with him? Leseho, do tell us where we can get you, or how do we get a hold of you?
It's on Twitter. It's at I am Holy One. On Instagram, it's I am Holy. And we'll put emails. We'll put, you know, phone numbers, gigs for jobs.
Put them there.
Please hire
me. And I saw you've been working really hard this weekend, even letting people know on social media, on Carve's page, that they should be sending through their stuff onto our platform. And there are a lot of young individuals out there that are looking forward to coming through to the show, sitting down with us and letting us know what they are good at. Like, udume ngani.
Yeah, I mean, but then the problem with that whole thing is that we need to, like, educate them on what to send exactly.
Sure,
because we can't just, like, you know, play a song. We don't know the background. Yeah. We don't know what's going on. We don't know where you're trying to be and whatnot. But we have a good show. We have a couple of people that we've got lined up for today.
Today is mostly about ticking off that checklist. You know, we're halfway through the year, and once you're there, a lot of people had goals that they have set, like New Year's resolution. Once in January, everybody had a whole list of, this is what I want to achieve for the year. And most people, or some people, have already achieved half of those things, or if not all of those things that they had on the list. So we want to find out from you, what about your goals? Have you, the goals that you have set, have you attained some of them? And how far are you willing to go to get through and get all those things that you want to have on your checklist?
How deep are you willing to swim to achieve your dreams and goals?
What are you willing to do? Get to the nitty gritty of it.
I mean,
we want to know.
It's essentially that, man. Like, it's July, like you say. So the half of the year is gone.
Sure.
Figure out Corey checklist, yeah, how far are you, you know, what have you achieved?
For you, let's start with you.
I think on a personal level, I'm screwed.
What goals have you said that you have achieved so far?
Yeah, man, I've finished a lot of things, that projects that are gonna come out that I feel very proud of, and I'm happy about. I wanted to finish something. I had a problem with not finishing things.
Okay, so now you are executing.
So now things are done, you know. I'm just waiting on people to play their end, but from my end, things are done. And we'll see. I feel like spring is gonna be good.
Okay, so are you, because I know for a fact that most of the stuff that I had on my list is already ticked off, to the point that by now I'm starting to get half-year goals. Yeah. Halfway through the year goals. Because most of the stuff that I had set out to achieve for since January, I've already achieved most of them. I mean, we're here for a second show, finally doing it. And Carve is something that I have been planning for like years.
I remember we spoke about this in December 1st. Actually, on the 2nd of January.
Exactly.
We had a meeting about this.
Yeah. So I'm glad that we're finally at the point where we can actually see Carve actually happening. We're executing. We're on our execution phase. Soon we'll be popping up in a whole lot of events, and you're going to find us there with our banners and everything. You're going to know. You're going to know more about us. All you have to do is stay on our Carve platforms. We are at Carve_radio on Twitter and on Instagram. Do follow follow us, interact with us, let us know and send us through what you're doing so that we can profile you, so we can give you a call and find out from you what you're doing to achieve all those goals that you have. Last week we spoke about envy, someone who was who has been in the industry for more than 10 years doing music.
Envy did the thing. I think that's the first song we're gonna play. It was a single, I think. I'm not sure if it's gonna be on the album.
Okay.
But it was a single, and it's a dope, you know, Guaidori's type of joint.
Okay.
But you know, Envy does the things. The video
A lot of people told me that they actually know Envy.
Yeah, you're the only one. Though.
People were like, "How do you not know Envy?" Glad that finally today we're gonna play a track by Envy.
Yeah, and we have to appreciate and say thank you to the big homie for sending through the music.
Thank you so much, Envy. I can't wait to hear your music.
Yeah, so it's like I said, I'm not sure if this is on the album, but it's a dope joint, I think, you know. So I think we can hear it now.
Okay, let's take a listen to some Envy.
Scream for the big guy, cause the big boy bring noise in the big ride. How you gonna diss I when you confused like a fucking Jew living on a pigsty? Handshake in a star, riding shotgun but you hate on the car. How you show love when you hate from afar, knowing high jumps the only time you raise in the bar. Right, and the bars, you're a hella dude, beggar dude, me none of my gangs, not Fiella dude. You wonder why these broads fuck Giella dude, cause they see you got no future like Sierra dude.
Sierra dude. Sierra dude.
Understand who the stars be, man, we understand that you lame and your bars weak. When you hear a scream shotgun, you should run B, cause we ain't speaking about a car seat. Got blunt, so we lit it. Roam through the city in my chucks and a fitted. Causing mayhem, so you know that we did it. If I hear mommy got back, she can get it like.
Hi, Z, how you doing?
Hi, I'm good, thanks. How are you doing?
We're good, thank you. We're so sorry about the technical glitches that are happening up in the studio today. But we do have a segment called What's for Dinner. And in that segment, we're speaking to Z, who's all the way at work because she has a 9-to-5 and also she has a food blog. Z, tell us a bit about that. Why couldn't you be here in studio? Give us the reasons. Because
we're hungry. We're hungry.
We're angry and we're hungry.
Excuse the guys.
Give us the reasons.
Same.
We want to know.
The 9-to-5. It's the 9-to-5.
All right. Okay. We'll forgive you.
The 9-to-5 got a bit demanding. So, yeah.
All right. We'll forgive you if next time you bring something scrumptious.
Please do the right thing. Tell us what you've made. Because you were supposed to come to studio with something for us to grab. Tell us what you made.
Okay. So, an example of a Sunday lunch that we could have.
Yeah.
It would be a grilled chicken. So you can choose to make it plain or have a flavored peri-peri or Portuguese chicken, whatever suits you. And you can have maybe a lamb curry or a lamb stew.
All right.
And then mashed potatoes and then roasted veggies.
Okay.
And then maybe cream spinach.
Was that what we want to...
Wow. It hurts to know that's what I was going to eat. I'm really touched. Sure. You mentioned a whole lot of great food.
No, next time, guys.
Z, okay, let's talk a bit about your passions. Okay. How did you get into the whole food blogging industry?
So I started cooking a while back, I think since varsity as a hobby. And then last year I started cooking even more because, you know, when you start working, you end up having the money to buy all of the stuff so you can make all of the fancy food that you want to pay for. So I started doing that and I post the stuff that I make. And then like I have a friend, she's in PR, and another one who's a digital manager. So she was like, no, why don't you open a blog and eventually you can blog and everything? Because I used to post my stuff on Twitter and on Instagram. So eventually they keep pushing me and I was like, okay, fine, let me start my own food blog. So yeah, I started with that and then eventually the brand just started growing. And yeah, now I'm here.
And speaking of you being here, you're doing a whole lot of events. Tell us a bit about what this point is that you're speaking of.
Yeah, on Sunday or Saturday, you have something going on, right? Tell the view and the listeners about that.
Oh, okay. So as last month, I started this thing called Wine with ZZ. So basically, that's a normal tasting session. And I started it because because I'm a wine enthusiast, right? So a lot, I'd post like a bottle that I drink on Twitter and Instagram. Then people would be like, no, like what's this bottle? What does it have? And everything. So eventually I was like, okay, so clearly people want to know more about wine. And I was like, since we don't have a second bottle here, why not try to bring it to them? So what I do is I host intimate wine sessions with these guys called Toasted Barrels. And then so they're very clued up on wine and they see that's just a daily job. So they're the ones who conduct the sessions. And then I keep them small so that it can be an interactive session. So
and
the next
of,
one on Saturday
know,
that's happening, it's good. Pardon?
Yeah, no, sorry about that. You can carry on.
Okay, that's fine. So the one that's happening on Saturday, it's going to be wine and chocolate pairing. Because I don't want to just keep it bland and because people are going to get bored of just tasting wine every month. So yeah, we try to keep things interesting and yeah.
So when are you thinking you like alcohol, when? That's the thing. You just drink. Everything
no, she
is
understands
wine,
nice
wine,
things.
Wine and this,
like,
wine and
no,
chocolate.
Pairing is important. Kausani, please tell them about the importance
wine
of pairing.
And bread.
Hey.
I'm saying, please tell them about the importance of pairing because wines, you can't just have a Sauvignon Blanc with whatever you want to eat.
Sauvignon,
it goes with something else. Can you tell us about the importance of that and why you decided
so
now
is,
to exploit the chocolate route of
okay,
things?
So Okay, so the importance of pairing in a whole, if you pair a meal with the wrong bottle, type of wine, you're going to end up mixing your flavors and you won't enjoy the wine or you won't enjoy the meal. Because, like, you know how you get your light-bodied meals and heavy-bodied meals? Even with wine, you get light-bodied wines and heavy-bodied wines. So if you look at stuff like your chicken, your fish, those you do, with, you could do a champagne. You can do a light or heavy-bodied wine, white wine, though. Because you imagine eating fish with red wine. Like, the red wine is going to take over the fish's taste. So the thing is, so you have to make sure that the wine that you're having and it complements the food that you're having, the flavors, the spices, and everything in it, so that they don't get lost into each other. So what I did for, when I chose chocolate, it was because like, I'm trying to get everyone used to the whole wine and food pairing. So chocolate was an easier step to start with. And also, you can also think about it as a dessert pairing because some people don't know what to pair like such desserts with or even such flavors with.
How can they?
So before we get into the actual food, you can start with like different flavors of chocolate and understand how wine and chocolate, like wine and flavor goes together. And then we can explore more foods.
Yeah, aren't there only two types of wines? There's white and red, right?
No.
it's not just two. I thought it was just two.
Listen, I can't.
But like how? We are in the store. In the store where I buy my alcohol.
I can't.
There's only like
you
red and
so
white.
there's actually nine types of wine.
So there's a blue one and there's a white one and a green one and a brown one.
No.
Okay.
So you have, so like you mentioned, you get your red and white, right?
Okay.
And then you can have light-bodied red and heavy-bodied red, and then light-bodied white, heavy-bodied red, and then you have your dessert menu, your dessert wines, which are usually like your sherry, like the more sweet or more bland stuff, and then you have rosé, and then you have sparkling wine, which is your champagnes, and yeah.
So you think this industry,
so, yeah,
tell us a bit about the food blogging industry. Do you think it's something that you might convert to apart from having your 9-to-5? Is it something that you might want to do permanently?
Pardon, please repeat the first part.
I'm talking about the food blogging industry. Would you, is that something that you would look forward to doing as a permanent job instead of like a part-time gig?
Yeah, definitely, because that's what I like to do the most. And like, because last week I actually had a Flora masterclass, and like the whole day we just spoke about food and we cook and we're drinking bubbly and everything. So like I realized that like that is actually what I want to do. So yeah, if the opportunity does come up, I definitely explore this industry, like maybe get like be a brand ambassador for this and work with brands, because literally that's what makes it bigger for you. Like you can just pair up with brands and start working with them.
Oh, so you just wanna drink for a living? Like when I,
but it's a food blog. It's not just about wine. Listen,
oh, okay.
No,
all I heard was wine.
You know, like he's just trying to push this whole wine thing. And Z, I can feel your vision. I feel your vision.
I mean, Z, have you reached any of your targets for your blog? Because that's what we're talking about now. Checklisting. You know, have you set up any goals and you know, marks for your blog?
So the aim for this year was to get my blog numbers up.
Okay.
And actually, the funny thing is, in May, I had higher numbers than in November when I actually started the blog, which was a very big month for me because I did put in the work for it.
Oh, okay.
And so, yeah, so I wanted to get the numbers up, which now I have, and get recognized by big brands.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, so like I said, I went to the Flora Masterclass, and then I went to the launch of the Carnelian at The Rock at Design Court and Four Ways, and I'm also trying to work some stuff with Snow. So they just like give me, so I'll say I want to make this tonight, and they're like, okay, you know, why don't you make it like this, and then I'll take the suggestions, I'll make that, and I'll share the recipes as well. So yeah, so now it's just more, now it's more about like actually getting a partnership with a brand, because so I've seen the students that follow me.
Right.
So yeah, the people are looking, like they are recognizing me now. So it's just like I have to get work from them.
Wow, that's amazing, Z. Thank you so much for sharing your time with us. We know that you have to go because you have a whole meeting to go to. Please email us the food.
Yeah, can you please like Uber Eats?
Uber Eats the food. Then, figure out a delivery system for us to get the food, please.
Before you go, tell the people where to find you and where.
Yes,
to...
how do we get in touch with you so that we can hopefully try to also get your numbers to go even further up?
Okay, cool. So on Twitter, you can hit me up on zzpro_za or on my blog's account, which is at zzthefoodie.
Okay.
And then on Instagram, it's zzpro_za. And then you can check out my blog. It's zzthefoodie.wordpress.com. Okay. And then on that, I have my email address there as well, which is zzthefoodie@yahoo.com.
Yes, well, we hope you get those private gigs that you want and for those brands to recognize you and actually grab you. And once they do, please partner with us too so that we can get food on a daily. Okay,
yes,
girl?
Yes, please.
And anyway,
your event, your event is sold out, right?
I got you guys.
On Saturday, it's sold out, right?
Hey.
Your event.
Yes.
It's sold
out. Yeah, so I sold the last few tickets last week. So today I announced that like it's sold out.
Congrats. Shine, girl.
And people are like, oh, and I'm like, guys, you had so much time.
When is the next one? Because everybody will obviously will want to know when the next one is.
So that will be beginning of August. I was looking at having something for Women's Day, but I'm still trying to work on something. So the details will be out next week. I'm just trying to get this one out of the way.
All right.
Awesome.
So late next week, early that other week, we'll know.
Okay.
Awesome. Thank you so much for coming through speaking to us on the line, Z. Thank you so much and have yourself a wonderful evening. Yeah?
And thank you for having me, guys. Thank you. You too.
Goodbye.
Okay, now we're going to go play a song by a young kid from Attridgeville called Quandre. His song is going to be coming up in a minute. The name of the song is from a project called Intellectual Documentary of a King.
Mm.
What do you know?
That's too much. Too much English.
He's an 18-year-old from Pretoria. He grew up in a big church-loving family, and that's what groomed him to be a conscious rapper. Quandre. Okay, we don't have Quandre's track lined up yet, but let's go into our odd news. Let's look at what odd news do you have there?
Let's see. What I have is apparently there's African art that was stolen, right? I don't know by whom, but
somebody who just felt the need.
Yeah, so some Congolese guy says that art that was stolen from Africans and Africa should be returned, just like how art that was stolen during the Holocaust was returned to the Jewish people and etc. Right? So this guy is trying to have us in numbers and people to be like, yo, people who plundered through African history and all those things, please bring them back because they're valuable to us.
Okay.
And yeah, so that's what's going on with that guy. The guy's name is Sindika Dokolo.
Okay.
Yes.
And we know that right now in South Africa, we are currently celebrating the National Arts Fest that's currently running, that started on the 28th of June and it's ending sometime on the 8th of July. And that's where like a lot of people come through and exhibit their works when it comes to all things art. And the festival is taking place in Eastern Cape in Grahamstown. And it started off obviously because Nelson Mandela and Mama Albertina Sisulu are from there. The whole event started off, kickstarted with the celebration of their centenary, because this is the year when they were born, in 1918, I think.
Yeah.
Yes, that was, yeah. So it would have been 100 years this year for the birth of Mama Nelson Mandela, Tata Nelson Mandela and Mama Albertina Sisulu. So the celebrations were all about that. And the Grahamstown Festival is celebrating, it's been around for 44 years. 44 can you imagine? Years.
That's Dude. A long, that's a long time.
Hey,
so they were here during the struggle.
Yeah, they were celebrating art even in the struggle, which is something that's quite cool, because now that we found like a lot of directors and theater makers of the time that made music and like your for this period that we're currently on. Okay. And can you guess this year?
Yeah.
This festival contributes 94 million into the economy of Grahamstown and 377 million into the economy of the Eastern Cape. So who says art doesn't bring the shankura?
Yeah, me. Can I have just put my 5% of the money?
Who says art doesn't bring the shankura?
Speaking of art that brings shankura,
mm-hmm.
last week Ed Sheeran broke the internet.
Of course.
The Cape Townians are not happy at all because one show sold out in a matter of an hour.
So to Cape Town.
It's crazy, man. Like, one show sold out in like an hour. 9 o'clock a.m. in the morning, tickets went on sale. And then by 10:30, the system was broken.
Wow.
No more tickets at all.
Yeah, obvious. I mean, get children. What do you expect, Len? Why did you not run to go get your tickets? I think that's the thing. Like, how Z was saying that people were surprised that there are no tickets anymore because it's sold out. But you need to, you know, if you're recognizing that you love this artist or you love what this person does, go grab a ticket, show some love immediately. But that's exactly what we did in SA. Cape Town, clearly, y'all are loving him that much.
Can you believe that this whole chaos is for next year, March? The show is only in March next year.
Yep.
And Joburg added a second night for him on the 27th, I think, and the 29th of March, 23rd and 24th.
Mm.
They added another show because people apparently like Ed Sheeran.
Can we talk about how many international artists love coming to South Africa? Because TLC is coming, SWV is coming.
I mean, that's
Drew
Hill
is coming.
Erykah Badu
is coming. Everybody
wants to call Tyrone. You know?
Oh gosh, you just had to do that. Okay, because his middle name is Tyrone.
No,
everywhere he goes.
Correction.
It's
first
your first name.
First name
is Tyrone. So everywhere he goes, he just wants people to be calling Tyrone.
Like, I mean, like Erykah Badu is a big deal, man, and Just TV Delicious are doing the things.
They're doing the things,
yeah. Whoever is in charge of the whole content, whatever you want to call it, is doing a good job, because every year they keep on doing the fire things.
Yes. Also, tell us about like art competitions. There are quite a lot of art competitions that are happening.
Yes.
So for upcoming people, emerging artists, here's a platform where you can actually apply yourself and actually find yourself in those industries. Cannot know there are no platforms, because people are actually making a whole lot of art competitions out here in order for you to grab the Zaga Zing and also get a platform to showcase your work on big scales.
All right, PPC Imaginarium 2019 competition. It's a competition, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, so it's a talent show, not like a talent show, like a talent show.
Yeah.
But essentially, you show up and you design and you make modern art. Mm. And
out of cement, by the way. That's why it's called the PPC Imaginarium.
Yes.
It's done out of cement. Can you imagine
that? And not only if you win, now you'll be mentored towards creating better work for yourself.
Sure.
And you will get, boom, 50,000 Mandelas.
100,000 actually for the overall winner.
Is and it 100,000
yeah,
for the...
100,000 for the overall winner. And then the category winners will each get like 50,000.
Yeah.
And then the runner-up for that will get 15 grand. I mean... Can you imagine? That's enough to get you and your company started.
You know how many cement bags you can buy with 50,000?
Okay, but no. That's not... Obviously, when you start out, maybe you'll be doing cement jewelry because the categories are like jewelry, sculpture, fashion. They make entire garments out of cement. It's amazing. You need to check it out. The closing date for that is, of course, the 30th of November. So do check out their page. They're on www.ppcimaginarium.com.
What you got?
And
I know you got something.
Yes, of course. I have a competition that closes tomorrow.
so if you are ready and you've been lacking the platforms, this is it.
It closes tomorrow.
Go
so
buy the data.
You need to legit, like, literally be on it. This is a platform. It's a competition by Cecil called Limitless. Yeah? And what it does is that it's pushing artists to push beyond contemporary art and go through and do limitless works.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
And then and it closes tomorrow.
It closes tomorrow.
What is the criteria?
The criteria is that you send through your works. Actually, just go on the page because there's a whole PDF entry form that you have to go through. But they literally just want to see how you can take normal art and change it into something else.
Yeah.
And what you got to do, just go to www.cecilsignatures.co.za and see if you could be one of those limitless
Cecil,
artists.
I almost did not make it here today.
Ish, because of the whole petrol thing.
Like, there was no petrol in my area. Like, and then, you know, I had, you know how many quantums I must travel to come here if I had to go and do that thing. So, like, petrol, there was no petrol in my area because batava dilivanga petrol, and I was on like 90 km, so I wasn't gonna reach this destination.
So
you almost
essentially, I was just gonna be talking to myself because Z didn't bring the food.
and our guest is actually not here. We're gonna speak to him on the phone.
Our guest is not here. We were supposed to get P Dot in studio. He couldn't be here either because he's releasing his album today.
Yeah, he's dealing with an album release, man. I feel like I've been bothering the brother, man.
Yeah, but he came through for us. He has a great WhatsApp message for us. But we're going to first play his song. But do let us know. We still want to get commentary from you from what you think about the whole goal settings that we have. I mean, we've set out goals in the beginning of the year and we said, okay, you want to achieve 1, 2, 3. Have you achieved those things? What are you willing to go through to get all those things? And what are you doing to change the space? And why those goals, actually? Because sometimes you come through with goals that are not really for you. Or have you changed your mind throughout the year where you realize that you've been rerouted into another direction? So do let us know. You do know where to get us at this point. We are at @Carve_radio on Instagram and Twitter because we really look forward to hearing from you. Well, are we going to play the P-Dot song?
Are we playing a song or are we going commercial?
Are we playing a song?
We're going to commercial and then after that we get the song.
Let's take a quickie.
We'll be right back.
You're listening to brandlive.co.za.
The station with the
best music.
Best music.
I love the music.
Best music.
1-0. This one's explosive.
Brandlive.co.za.
You know life can be so ordinary. Boy meets girl, they said I'll make a baby.
Brandlive.co.za.
In your face, all over the place. We're online 24/7. 24/7. You're listening to the hottest internet station.
Brand Live.
No doubt.
Okay.
Making a bold statement yet blending into the surrounding suburbs of Melville, 27 Boxes is a realization of edgy design and practical implementation. A radical departure from the shopping malls of our generation, yet not a return to the high streets of our youth. 27 Boxes showcases the best of a shopping center set in a garden, surrounded by the bohemian suburb that is Melville. 27 Boxes, shop, play, eat. Megan Verne is South Africa's dynamic young speaker who shows her skills in areas of assisting attendees to realize their potential through showing them what is possible if you believe in yourself and take charge of your destiny. No matter the age or size of her audience, from 5 to 5,000 people, Megan touches a chord with her honest outlook and natural frankness. She has spoken to corporate staff meetings to lift team morale. Trainers use Megan within their sessions to add another dimension to their presentations. And her talks take people out of their comfort zones and encourage them to look at the way they approach their lives and work relationships differently. Megan is often sponsored by corporates to speak at schools around the country as part of their CSI initiatives. Visit www.meganverner.co.za now.
Brandlife.co.za is thought leadership radio. It's a new way to communicate your brand, your value, and what you think about your industry. Be a leader.
You'll never stop at one. I'll take you all along.
Be a voice.
I have a dream.
And we will help you shape your industry. Our radio platform is for thought leaders who want to share insights, businesses who want to create value for their databases, organizations who want to control their message, for those that drive change. Make your brand come alive on brandlife.co.za, harnessing the power of talk radio.
We'll be right back.
Harnessing the power of talk radio. Brandlive.co.za.
Oh yeah, yeah. Yeah. They told me to get in my key. My homies are counting on me. Mommy is waiting on me. Kunini si sama mama. I could have just made it on time. Kunini si panda mama. They told me to read and believe. It's time to one thing I got. Kunini been grinding to get it. They hate me, they love me, don't get it. I wanna be thriller for years. The future is not what they say. That's getting cold, I ain't lonely. Bango, they show me love. This is the one that's doing. The city is ours, new it. Haters are hating with Kevin. 2018, I'll be frozen. This is for all those who thought it's a young 2016. How was it come up? They couldn't discuss me. I'm keeping it distant. People like that, they can't be strangers. Some of my homies are changing to haters. I knew it, we secretly hating. First ones that don't mean a thing. Reason I don't hold a bed. Peaceful decisions, I'm waiting for autumn, I'm waiting for rain. Happy in the autumn, I'm waiting for Eve. Ways by yourself, the one who believes. I'm feeling the pressure, I got a elite. Shout out to cousins and cousins of cousins who can't let you know. They told me to get in my D. My homies are calling on me. Mommy is waiting on me. Who need it since I'm a mom? I couldn't spend it on time. Who need it since Panama? They told me they really believe. They told me one thing to do. They told me to get in my key. My homies are counting on me. Mommy is waiting on me. Kunini si zama mama. I could have just made it on time. Kunini si panda mama. They told me they really believe. It's time they want till I die. How many years I've been waiting? Can't count the man I've been spending. You are the one. You told me you needed some time. You was the one, we couldn't, we ran out of time. You was the one, who gave up on time. I'm out here counting my blessings. I'm finna be 30 and feel rich. Gotta be home when it's dinner time. I wanna look out for my family. I wanna find mama a bigger crib. I'm ready, they possible win. I had a dream and they knew it. Exes were blocking the boy. Crashes began in the boy. My heart and my soul in my music. Look where he coming right now. Pull up on people I knew. I got no reason to love you again. Most of your numbers ain't listen. These days I'm handling my fifths. She and my homies with DMs. They told me to get in my D. My homies are calling on me. Mommy is waiting on me. Who need it since I'm a mom? I couldn't just spend it on time. Who need it since Panama? They told me they really believe. It's only one thing to do. They told me to get in my key. My homies are counting on me. Mommy is waiting on me. Kunini si zama mama. I could have just made it on time. Kunini si panda mama. They told me they really believe. It's only one till I die. It's only one till I die. It's only one till I die. On the one till I die. Tess, I will run in the city.
Back to Carve Radio, you know it. Our handle is @Carve_radio on Instagram and Twitter. Interact with us, let us know what you think, because we really do look forward to hearing from you. And today's topic, we were talking about your goals and if you've reached them, whether you are halfway through your goals for the year or if you're already done with everything and you're actually even starting new goals. And we have someone on the line who just released an album, right?
Yeah. P, are you on the line?
Hello, P Dot.
Yeah, what's up?
Hey, what's up, homie?
I'm easy, man. How you guys doing?
Man, we're good. Hey, man, just tell us about everything, man. Everything, man. How does it feel, man? Second album off the shelf.
I'm feeling it. It's a great energy about it, man. Like, the reception has been crazy. Album is called Under the Sun, and I couldn't be happier right now. You know, I'm just really like kind of letting people soak it in more than anything.
All right. And then and please explain to us what Under the Sun is, man.
Being under the sun.
I was chilling out.
Under the Sun is like a play on, they look at Africa as the home of the sun. Like Africa is where the sun was born. So I'm also like looking at it in two ways. Under the Sun, where, you know, Africa is the father of the sun, and I'm also like, you know, because I'm very spiritual.
Mm-hmm.
So under the sun, I'm also under God's sun, under his sun. It was that kind of, you know, thing.
All right.
And I hope I explained well.
No, I get you. I mean, I'm looking at the track list. That's like 14 joints and then an additional 3 joints, right?
Yes, sir.
That's a long body of work, man. Like, have you said everything you want to say, or what's going on?
Yeah, I'm already like, you know, conceptualizing the next album. I got too much to say.
Yeah, because when
go ahead. Even like we had to cut some songs out. I mean, I couldn't make it a 20 album track, so there's just too many songs that we recorded, and I felt like
because these a songs, month ago,
like, it makes sense.
Because when I saw you a month ago, you're like, yo, man, send me a joint. I'm like, isn't this nigga's album done?
Yeah, you know, we have to just keep working, man. That's what it's about.
Yeah, man, I see
Yeah, I'm really enjoying the energy. Enjoying the energy, and people seem to be responding well. So, yeah, it's a good thing.
All right, man. I see a lot of interesting features here, man. Explain to me, like, what happened? How did you get to choose people like Flex Boogie, Angie Santana, and all these other people that I see? Obviously, the Envays, the Black Leses are there, but, I mean, like, Flex Boogie has been, you know, I haven't heard from him in a while, and now he's on your album.
Yeah, you know, that dude is like, you know, is one artist that I respect immensely, like, because he's a complete artist.
Yeah.
You know, he's a complete artist. He's an author now, and, you know, he's vocally he's strong. You know, he's a great rapper, he's a great performer. He's like a complete artist. I've always had respect for him. I didn't feature a lot of rappers this time, unlike my first album.
Yeah.
I just wanted to keep it minimal. And majority of the rappers that are actually on the album are not, like, big names or no names, especially. I think I have, like, 3 well-known names, and then the rest are, like, you know, like, guys that are still on the come-up.
Yeah.
I didn't want to focus too much on the features. There's way more vocalists on this one.
Yeah, I'm looking at it.
Yeah, it came together very well. I'm very grateful.
Oh, but are you happy with what you put out, man? Because it's out. It's in the ether, man. Like,
yeah.
You know, people only hear it.
That's what happens. Like, once the music is out, it forms a life of its own. There's nothing you can do. I can't, like, bring it back and try to reshape it now. It's gone. So I'm very happy. I'm very, very happy.
All right, so the album dropped at midnight, right? Last night.
Yes, sir. This morning. At midnight.
Yeah. And then it's on every platform, iTunes, or what's going on?
Yes, sir. It's on every platform, Deezer, Joox. The physical copies are coming. The launch is also coming.
When's the launch? Tell us about the launch, man. We want to be there in the
launch
mix.
Launch is actually on the 27th of July.
Where?
It's going to be at the State Theater.
Obviously.
But we'll have an official announcement of it, so people can come through, and there will be performance, like a real performance, so people can really understand what I was trying to do better.
All right, nah, man. I see that from the track listing, and based on the material that I know from you, it should be dope. And what are you doing this week, man? Like, what's going on? Are you on some, you know?
Yo, like, we're gonna be starting rehearsal this week, my brother, for the show on the 27th.
Okay.
You know, that's basically what we're focusing on. Pardon, man?
Are you working on any videos that we should be expecting to see on television anytime soon?
Yes, ma'am. That was the first official video for this album.
Okay.
Yeah, and then I dropped another one called I'm No Vulture.
Yeah.
So the next one's going to be for Angels. That's the one that we're shooting next.
Okay, is it Boma Disco Light type of videos, or is there actually storyline those videos?
Is it what?
Is it Boma Disco Light the type of video, or is there a storyline in your videos?
Are they women twerking there? Because
I want to twerk. Where are they?
Nah, me, like, this album, I really want people to really, like, listen and think it was that kind of album. Mm. You know, I think we've got enough material out there that offers the other side of life where people can twerk and dance and do their thing. This one is like, I want people to really sit down, like reading a book, like sit down,
but then think, what about sit down simmer. Tracks in the club? How are you gonna make sure you get tracks in playing in the club?
I think that's the 90s way of, you know, doing things. Like back in the 90s, they used to say, okay, we're gonna have a song for the club, then we're gonna have a song for the ladies, then we're gonna have a song for the street. You know what I mean? That's how they used to do it. But now that really doesn't matter. It's about just a body of work that people connect with. You know, you can make 10 songs that are club songs. People love it. That's the album. You know, this one is not really geared for that.
My G, I'm looking. Yeah, man, go ahead. I'm sorry.
No, I'm just saying the next video is Angels. It's going to be very, very dark. Very, 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 very dark. I want people to cry. All right,
we
wow,
got you.
Okay, we must expect to cry.
Very,
we must
very,
cry.
Very, very, very dark. I can't wait. Yes,
Rola.
Are they going to be dark tour cars as well?
What's wrong with you?
I mean, the storyline can have twerkers as well. Okay, no, my G, listen, I'm gonna tell people, like, an album is a very personal thing to some people, you know, and I hope people understand what you're trying to say and where you're coming from and the picture that you're trying to paint. You know, I hope it doesn't get lost.
Yes,
yeah, I hope it doesn't get lost in this wave.
It's easy to put together 10 great songs that are commercially viable, and it's like a compilation. And people call it an album. I want people really, really, I want to make something that's going to be relevant 10 years from now. And I don't want it to just fizzle away.
All right.
And that's what we focus on so much. Albums that next year they've forgotten. I don't want it to be that kind of situation.
So is this an album we should be expecting to hear on being nominated for some of our big awards in South Africa? Or are you not about awards? Are you not fazed by that?
It's God willing, obviously I would be very, very, every artist wants to be appreciated for their craft. So I would be lying if I said I'm not fazed. That would be a great, great achievement. And I proclaim it. I claim it. Thank you, madam.
Yeah. Take it. Receive it, man.
Amen. Amen. Good luck. Good luck with everything, man. I hope, I really hope it comes
out the way that you guys. I appreciate you.
Thank you so much.
Bona, we're gonna try play one of your songs after here, but then time is a bit of a thing. But we really appreciate you taking time out to listen to us.
Thank you. I appreciate you guys. Thank you. God bless.
All right, cool, man.
Well, everybody, that was P. Dot on the line talking to us about his newly released album. What's the title again?
Under the Sun.
Under the Sun.
Yes.
Uchizi, you know, he wants you to be that kind of person. Sip on something, chill under the sun, listen to his album. You know, reflect. He says he's gonna drop an album called Angels. That's
a song called Angels.
That's gonna make us cry and I guess reflect some more.
I'm trying to see twerkers though.
Peter the Udag.
Yeah, no, man, he's a cool guy, man. Like his music as well is very, like, you know.
Yeah.
He's thoughtful and like that's why I told him, like, I hope people understand what he's trying to do.
Okay.
Because he's very, like, emotional with his music and.
Well, I guess he's certainly one to be on the lookout for.
Yeah,
so
we'll definitely be at the State Theater.
Mm-hmm.
What else is happening
at the State Theater?
The Youth Expression Festival. Yeah, you know, same old. State Theater
we're wrapping
representing.
Up Youth Month.
Yeah.
Well, we've already wrapped up Youth Month, but the Expression Festival is still currently underway.
Same thing. They're marking like a big landmark, like 42 years, right? So it's 42 years since the Soweto Uprising.
Okay.
Yeah, man. You know, I mean, hey, man, State Theater never. Come on.
Are we getting P. Dot song? Do we have P. Dot song? I really want to hear
the
one
conversion.
Of the
I don't know what's going on here.
Okay, well, from what it looks like that's what we have for today's show.
Well, I have one more thingy, one more gig guide. No, I have to
okay.
do this.
Okay, he's been wanting to do this. Okay.
For my Caucasian brothers and sisters, we do not leave you in the dark.
Mm-hmm.
We've got Snue Virgi. FNAF.
Snue Virgi.
FNAF 21 to 29 July 2018. Lief die Fantasie Wereld. Van Sproskies en Romansie, by die Stars Theater van die klassieke verhaal van Snor Virke. Op die opera verhoog, uitspeel as 'n Afrikaanse pantomime die Afrikaanse word meer school.
What does that mean? Okay, let us know, where is this event?
It's at the State Theater. It's at the State Theater on the 21st, 29 July. It's for my Caucasian brothers and Caucasian sisters. It's Snow White. Snowy Virgi. They have a very looking Caucasian woman on the front. Like, she's like, she's very Caucasian.
Yes, because it's
no, but like, she's like from the mountain of Caucasus. Say grey, jo karkis, somar vandaag nog en berg en breng die hele gezin naar vanner. Yes, yeah, okay. Yeah, my Afrikaans is done. It's done.
I can't.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, no, definitely we. That's a way to exit. Like,
yes.
Yeah, before we ruin it, before Brand Life says they're not giving us
before
a platform
again.
Yeah. It's okay. That's all we have for you on today's show. Check us out same time, same place next week, right here on Brand Life's platform. We are Carve Radio.
Yes.
Find us on Twitter and Instagram at Carve_radio.
Affirmative.
Yes.
Correct.
And we will be back next week with more exciting content that's going to be profiling more of the youth, showcasing what they're doing best, giving you a gig guide, talking to a couple of people that are kicking ass in the industry.
I mean, let's try to get like a live performer. I can get like a...
That would be nice.
I got this guy, looks violin player.
That would be nice. Live performance?
Yeah, like a live violin player.
Let us know what you think on Carve_radio. Who would you like to hear? What kind of instrument would you be down for? Can we even have that kind of thing in studio?
Can we mic it up? Yes, we can.
Yes, we can. Okay, yes. We'll definitely bring a live performance in studio next week. Or maybe we should just do it a once a month thing, you know? Who knows?
But people on my WhatsApp is like, I can't even pronounce Snowy.
Like, what are you trying? Like, what are you trying?
Snowy Vicky.
You know what? It's a wrap. It's a goodbye from us.
See you next week. Bye-bye, people.
I get more gigs than you do on your service provider. I'm not a liar. Ooh. Coming at you like the stone that was rocking with David. Killing Goliath. Ooh.
Dave, bring that shit, man.
Aye, working hard again. Working hard again. Working hard again.